Hi friends, welcome to Tech Trends. In this video, we can see how to control a DC water pump using the latest Blink app, that is Blink IoT. Let's get started. The components required for this experiment are Node MCU board, DC water pump, relay, 9 volt battery, connecting cable, connecting wires, and a tube to connect with the pump. First, we can connect the 9 volt battery to the breadboard. So, this is the positive pin, and this black is the negative pin. So, connect in two points in the breadboard. Now connect the relay module with the breadboard. So the relay has three pins, signal, positive and the negative. Connect the positive with the positive wire which we connected from the battery and the negative with the negative wire from the battery. And the signal pin connect with pin number D4 in the Node MCU board. First I am connecting the negative with the negative in the breadboard. Next connect the positive with the positive wire from the battery in the breadboard. Now connect the signal pin with the pin number D4 in the Node MCU board. So this is pin number D4. You can use any pin, but you need to change the Blink app based on the pin which you selected. Now we have two more connections from the Node MCU board. Connect the VIN pin from the Node MCU board to the positive and ground to the negative pin from the battery in the breadboard. Now we connected the relay and Node MCU and the 9 volt battery in the breadboard. So for time being I am removing this negative wire. So let's connect this one once we complete the connection with the pump. Now we need to connect the pump with the relay. So this is the DC water pump. So this pump has two pins, positive and the negative. The red wire is positive and the black wire is negative. Okay, connect the negative wire from the battery with the negative wire from the pump. And connect the positive wire from the pump with the first pin in the relay. And connect the positive wire from the pump with the second pin in the relay. Now we can connect the wire which we removed from the battery in the breadboard. Once we completed the circuit connection, dip this pump in the water. And after upload the code, we can check the output.
Log into the blink.cloud website. Select the template menu and go to new template. Here give any name for the template. And then select the device. Here we are using ESP8266 and select the connection type as Wi-Fi. And now click done. Next go to data streams and select new data stream and select the digital. Here give any name for the field and select the pin as 2, that means digital pin D4 in the device. Now click create. And then go to web dashboard. Here drag the switch widget and then go to settings and select the data stream and now click save and again click save from here. Now click the search icon and select new device and then select from template. Here, select the device name and then click Create. Now copy this template ID, device name and authentication code script to our program. Now select the board from Tools, NodeMCU, and then select the port. And now click this arrow button and upload the program to the NodeMCU board. Now the program is uploaded successfully to the board. Now we can set up the mobile dashboard and then we can check the output. To check the output, just press this button and the pump will turn on. And if you press again, the pump will turn off.
Download this Blink IoT app from the Play Store. Now open this app. Now here we can see the template which we created through Blink dashboard through the web. Click this template and then click Setup Dashboard. And here select the widget. We need to drag this button widget to the screen. Or just click on this button. Now again click on this button and give any title and select the data stream and select the mode as switch. Now go back and again go back. Now we created the button and now we can check the output.